Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to go over these probability problems that are based on a multivariate normal distribution. So in this case, we have a random vector x, which is a vector of three random variables that are normally distributed, and we know it's three because of the three here. And we are given the two parameters, so we're given the matrix of the means for x1, x2, x3, and we are given the covariance matrix of x. So the covariance matrix has the variances on the main diagonal. So this is the variance of x1, variance of x2, variance of x3, and then the off diagonal portions have the covariances. So this value, for example, is the covariance between x1 because it's the first row and x2 because it's the second column. And we can use that to find these different probabilities. So let's go ahead and get started with the first one. So this is just finding the probability that x1 is greater than 6. So the idea with this is we're going to write out what the normal distribution is for each of these transformations or parts of the given distribution, and then we're going to convert these to a z-score, and from the z-score we're going to use a z-table to find the probabilities. And you can find a z-table online, or I'll put a link in the description box to a PDF. Okay, so we're going to find the mu and the variance for x1 in order to convert it to a z-score. So looking at the mu vector, mu for x1 is just 5, and then the variance for x1 is just 4. So we know that x is normally distributed with mu or mean 5 and variance 4. The formula for a z-score is x minus mu over the standard deviation. So in that case, this is going to be x, which is what we are looking for, minus mu, which is 5, over the square root of 4, which is 2. This is going to give us 0.5. So the probability of z being greater than 0.5, on the table that I'm using, we're looking at lower than values. So this is equal to the probability z is less than negative 0.5 because of symmetry. And the probability that you get if you look this up on the table is 0.3085. And that's the answer for part A. So part A is done. Part B is a linear transformation of two random normally distributed variables. So there's a theorem that says that any linear combination of normally distributed variables is also normally distributed. So 5x2 plus 4x3, we can say that we know that that is normally distributed because we know that x2 and x3 are normally distributed. And again, we have to find mu and sigma. So let's go ahead and do that. For the mu, we just have to get the expected value of what we're asked to find. So the expected value is pretty straightforward. We just do the expected value of 5x2, which is equal to 5 times the expected value of 2, which is equal to mu 2 plus 4 mu 3. And if we look for x2 and x3, that's 3 and 7. So that's going to be 5 times 3 plus 4 times 7. And that's going to be 43. So mu is going to be 43. There is more than one way to find the variance, so I'll do one way for part B and another way for part D. So if it's just two variables, I think it's maybe easier to do just a binomial expansion. So 5x2 plus 4x3, multiply that by itself because you're finding the variance. And then if you multiply this out, that's 5x2 squared plus 40 times the covariance of x2, x3 plus 16 x3 squared. So this is equal to 25 of the variance of x2 plus 40 covariance x2, x3 plus 16 times the variance of x3. And then we are given the covariance matrix, so we can find the covariance of 2 and 3. And we're given the variances as well, obviously. So that's going to be 25 times the variance of x2. So that's going to just be 4 from looking at the covariance matrix. So that's that plus 40 times the covariance of x2 and x3. So 2, 3, that's 2. And then plus 16 times the variance of 3, and that will be 9. And if we add and multiply, that's going to be 324 for the variance. So 5x2 plus 4x3 is normally distributed with 43 as the mean and 324 as the variance. We're asked to find the probability that that is greater than 70. So when we find the z-score, we're going to do 70 minus 43 over the square root of 324. That gives us 1.5. So the probability z is greater than 1.5 is equal to the probability that z is less than negative 1.5, and that is equal to 0.0668 according to the table. And we are done with that problem. Now let's just do the last one, and this is looking at a linear transformation with the three variables. So I'm going to find variance in a different way. So let me just erase this so I don't have to scroll down too much. So D is asking to find the probability 4x1 minus 3x2 plus 5x3. So we want to find out again the mu and the variance. Doing the same thing as last time, this is going to give us 46. And then another way of finding the variance is using matrix multiplication. And I think with three variables or more, it's easier to use matrix multiplication. So this is going to be A times the covariance matrix X times A transpose. And this is matrix multiplication. So A is the coefficient vector in this case. So that's going to be 4 minus 3, 5 times the covariance matrix, which we are given, and it is 4, negative 1, 0, negative 1, 4, 2, 0, 2, 9 times A transpose, so that's 4, negative 3, 5. So if we do that, that's going to give us one single value at the end, but the steps are just doing matrix multiplication left to right. So that's 16 plus 3, negative 4 minus 12 plus 10, negative 6 plus 45, and then that's going to be times 4, negative 3, 5, and the final answer for the variance is 289. So we have that this is normally distributed with 46 as the mean and 289 as the variance. And again, like all the other problems, we're going to transform into a z-score that equals 2.0, and we are asked to find the probability that it's less than, so we don't have to use symmetry. So the probability that z is less than 2 is 0.9772, and we are done with this problem.